Welcome to my channel, students. I am discussing about that is BST test series, chemistry test series. The first question here, identify the correct matched pair. What is given? Bronze. Bronze is an alloy of copper and tin. So it is a mixture. Next, iron. Iron is a, only it is given only iron. So, iron is a pure substance. It is not a compound. Option A is wrong. Option B is wrong. Seawater. What is seawater? Seawater is a mixture of more number of salts. So, option C is the correct option. And naphthalene. What is naphthalene? Naphthalene is benzene ring. Two benzene ring meshed is naphthalene. So, this is also not a mixture. Our option is C. First question, the option is C. Second question, 240 Kelvin is equal to. So, we know that 0 degree Celsius is equal to 273.15 Kelvin. Now, this is 0. If it is 0 Kelvin. 0 Kelvin means what happens? This will come here. That is 0 minus 273.15. So, 0 Kelvin is equal to minus 273.15. And if it is 240 Kelvin is equal to 240 plus. So, if we know that you have to add 0 degree Celsius minus 273.15. That is 240 minus 273.15, which is minus 33.15. Our option is C. See, simply, we know that 273.13 Kelvin is 0 degree Celsius. If you decrease the Kelvin scale, this also will decrease. This decrease means will come in the negative value. So, it is negative of 33.15. Third question, for an experiment, students were required to weigh 3 gram of compound. So, 4 students were reported this. We have to calculate the precise, that means which student has given a precise and accurate value, that means which is close to 3 gram. See the deviation of the student A, this is 0.10, that is negative deviation, less, and this is 0.05 and this is 0.1. And see the student B. It is 0.05, 0.06 and this is 0.04. And student C, 0.02, 0.05 and 0.09. And student D, see here, it is 0.03, 0.01 and 0.01. So, while comparing this, this is deviated less. So, whether it is a positive or negative, this student has deviated less. So, he is close to the precise and accurate value. Our option for third question, the option is D. Fourth question, two containers of the same size are filled separately with oxygen and methane gas. CH4 is what? It is methane. Both of the containers are same temperature and pressure. So, what it is given? Temperature is same and pressure is same. We know that PV is equal to nRT. That means what they have given? P1 is equal to P2. That is both having same pressure. T1 is equal to T2. Both having same temperature. That means V1 is equal to nRT1. And here V2 is equal to nRT2. That means for same size and same size. So, it will be containing same number of volume also. V1 will be equal to V2. So, when comparing these two, what happens? So, P1 and P2 will be equal. V1 and V2 will be equal. R and R will be equal. T1 and T2 will be equal. Now, N will also be equal to N. That is, what is N? Number of moles. So number of moles is equal means the number of molecules will be same. The answer is number of molecules. The number of moles are equal because pressure, volume and temperature are same. Fifth question, which of the following reaction does not obey law of conservation of mass? So what is law of conservation of mass? Law of conservation of mass is mass in the reactant side is equal to total mass on the product side. So what happens here? Endothermic reaction means what? Heat energy is absorbed. Exothermic reaction means heat energy is released. What is neutralization reaction? Acid reacts with the base to give us salt and water is neutralization reaction. Here also energy will be. What is nuclear reaction? See, in this nuclear reaction, the mass is converted into energy. In nuclear reactions, we know neutrons will be involved. So, there will be deficiency in mass. That means what? The reactant in the mass in the reactant side is not equal to the mass in the product side. So, nuclear reaction, what happens? The defective mass, the mass is converted into energy and a large amount of energy is released. So, our option which does not obey the law of conservation of masses, our option is D, nuclear reactions. Dash, the smallest particle of matter was one of the assumptions of Dalton's. So, we know here, see, it is Dalton's atomic theory. What is this assumption? Atoms are the smallest particle. Our option is A. So, according to Dalton, atoms are the indivisible particle. Going to the next question. For which of the following, the atomicity is 1? See here, for helium, what is atomicity? It is number of atoms present. For helium gas, we know helium 2 does not exist. Does not exist. According to the molecular orbital theory, helium will be remaining as an atom. And for oxygen atom, oxygen gas, what is that? The atomicity will be 2. 2 atoms of oxygen are present. For H2O, you have 2 hydrogen plus 1 oxygen. So, the atomicity will be 3. For dry ice, what is dry ice? Dry ice, frozen carbon dioxide is dry ice. So, here also, carbon dioxide, you have 2 carbon, sorry, you have 1 carbon. And 2 oxygen. How much you have? You have 1 carbon and 2 oxygen. So, the atomicity is 3. Which is having atomicity 1 here? Helium. Our option will be A. For 7th question, the option is A. Eighth question, which of the following statement about a compound is incorrect? So, what is the question here? They are asking which is incorrect. A molecules of compound has atoms of same element. See, let us take NaCl. NaCl, it is having 2 different elements. So, this itself is an incorrect statement and the option is A. While checking this, see, a compound cannot be separated into constituent elements by physical methods. Yes, by filtration, we cannot separate Na plus and Cl minus. You need a chemical method to separate. Compound does not retain. See, for example, Cl2 is gas, but when NaCl is formed, it is a solid. So, it does not retain the physical property. Then, ratio of the atoms of different elements in a compound is fixed. That means what? NaCl means it is 1 Na and 1 Cl, not Na2Cl. This is wrong. The compound is fixed. So, our option is for 8th question, the option is A. One AMU. AMU means what? Atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit is equal to, this is known, one atomic mass unit is equal to 1 by 12th the mass of carbon C12 atom. See here, it is 1.6 × 10⁻²⁴ should come. So the answer is for the 9th question. It's a known one. The answer is A. The molecular mass of carbon monoxide, CO, it is given 28. What is the unit? So just known it, the molecular mass is, the unit of the molecular mass is U. The option for 10th question is C. Eleventh one, the mass of carbon present in 0.5 mole of potassium ferrocyanide. First, what is potassium ferrocyanide? Potassium ferrocyanide is K4FeCN6. Right. So, 1 mole of K4FeCN6 consists of how many grams of carbon? 6 into, you have C carbon is 6, 6 into 12 grams, which is 72. Now, 0.5 of K4C4 will be containing how much? That is 0.5 into 72 or half into 72, which is 36 gram. Our option will be D. Twelfth question. Which one of the following has maximum number of atoms? So, what is the formula to calculate number of atoms? Number of atoms is equal to N. N is number of moles into atomicity. So, what is N? N is number of moles, that is given mass by molecular mass. First, A1, we have to calculate 1 gram of Mg. So, what is number of moles? Given mass is 1 gram and the atomic mass is, molecular mass is 24. Into what is the atomicity of Mg? It is 1. Next, for B, 1 gram of O2. That is, given mass is 1. O2, 2 oxygen. 16 into 2 will be 32. Sorry, 16 into 2 is 32. Into, what is the atomicity of oxygen here? This 2. So, 1 by 16. Next, C1. 1 gram of lithium. This is 1 and atomic mass is 7. Atomicity is 1. It will be 1 by 7. And the D1. 1 gram of Ag. Again, 1 by 108 and atomicity is 1. So, it is 1 by 108. See, the numerator, which is having the more numerator, will be having less number. So, sorry, denominator. This is having the less denominator. The value of this will be more. Our option is C, which is having less denominator, the value will be more. If you are having more denominator, means the value will be less. Thirteenth question, which of the following species has the same percentage of carbon as CH3COOH? So, let us calculate the empirical formula, which will be very easy. CH3COOH means, how many carbon is there? Let us see, you have 2 carbon, hydrogen, you have 4 hydrogen, oxygen is 2. So, it can be divided by a common number 2. It is CH2O. This is for acetic acid. Let us calculate for A. A is C6H12O6. So, it can be divided by a common number 6. It is CH2O. See, this and this is having same empirical formula, will be having same percentage. Let us check B. This is C2H5OH. That means C is 2, H is 6 and O is only 1. It does not have a common numerical to divide. In this will be the empirical formula. For C1, C12, H22, O11, it is also not having a common number. Then this is the empirical formula, and D1, CH3OH. So, what is this? C, CH4O. This 3, 1 and 4. And this is CH4O. This is CH2O. So CH2O and CH2O is having the common empirical formula. They will be having the same percentage of carbon. Our option is A. 13th, the option is A. Equal moles of water and urea are taken in a flask. So it is given equal moles. Let us take moles of urea and water. So since it is equal moles, let us take this as X. Now to calculate the mass of urea. So what is urea? Urea is NH2, CO, NH2 is urea. NH2, CO, NH2 is urea. So you have 2 nitrogen, so 2 into 14 plus carbon will be 12 plus this is oxygen will be 16 plus hydrogen is 4. Totally it is 16. So mass of urea will be 60x. So, you know, given mass by molecular mass and number of moles, which is X is equal to given mass by molecular mass. So, given mass is, let us take molecular mass is 60 and this is X, 60X. Next, mass of water. Mass of water is equal to, we know water is H2O, 2 plus 16, that is 18X. Now, what is mass percentage? Mass percentage is equal to mass of the solute. What you have to take? Let us take mass of urea that is given by total mass. Total mass of the solution. What is the mass of urea? It is 60x plus total mass is 60x plus 18x. That is 60x by 78x. So, cancel, you will be getting 60 by 78. So, percentage, it should be multiplied by 100. Cancel 30 and this is 39. So, 3000 by 39, you will be getting 77%. So again, you can say 1000 by 30. So we'll be getting 77%. Our option is C. Next, 15th question, molality M of 18M H2SO4. So what are the data given? They have given molarity. Molarity is denoted by capital M. Capital M is 18M they have given. Next, what is given? Density. Density is given as 1.84 gram centimeter inverse. Next, what is given? Molar mass. That is, molar mass is equal to 98. So, if molarity and density is given, formula to calculate the molality is 1000 into molarity, M for molarity, by 1000 into density minus molarity into molecular mass. That is, molarity is M, molarity into molecular mass. So 1000 into what is M? M is 18 divided by 1000 into what is density? 1.84. And what is molarity? Minus 18 into what is molecular mass? It is 98. So you will be getting 18 by, this is 1840. So three zeros, three decimals. Minus 18 into 98 will be 1764. Just calculate. So it is 18,000 by 76. This is 4. When you are 4 dividing by 4, 4500, and this is 119. So if you divide 4500 by 119, you will be getting approximately 236.8. The answer is 237. So for 15th question, the answer is D. Sixteenth question, Millikan performance oil drop experiment to find the charge of the electron. This is a theoretical question. 16th question, the answer is A. To find the charge of the electron, he did the oil drop experiment. 17th question, silicon and phosphorus have same number of. So, silicon is given, what is atomic number is 14 is given. So, number of protons will be 14. Number of electrons will be 14. And what is neutrons? Neutrons will be mass number minus this atomic number. That is 30 minus 14. 30 minus 14 will be 16. Here for phosphorus, number of protons is 15. Number of electrons is also 15. And what are the number of neutrons? It is 31 minus 15. So, 31 minus 15, which is 16. So, which is equal in this two? Number of neutrons is equal. Our answer is neutrons. 17th one, the option is C. 18th one, which of the following has different number of electrons than argon? So, argon, you have to know. Argon, the atomic number is 18. Number of electrons is 18. So, for A, it is K plus. K, the atomic number is 19. Plus means what? Loss of electron. So, number of electron will be 19 minus 1 is 18. And for B, Ca, 2 plus. Calcium, the atomic number is 20. So, loss of 2 electrons. Plus means loss of 2 electrons. The electrons will be 18. And for C, chlorine minus. Chlorine, we know the atomic number is 17. If it is minus means, what is this? One electron is gained. So, number of electron is here 18. And option D1, it is given S minus. So, what is the atomic number of sulfur? Sulfur is 16. So, 16, it gains one electron. So, how many electrons it will be? Now, it is 17. So, which does not matches with argon is S minus. Our option is D. 19th question. The ratio of frequency of radiation with wavelength 400 nanometer to the frequency of radiation with wavelength 760 nanometer. So, what they are asking? Frequency. So, we know that wavelength is equal to lambda is equal to C by F. C is the velocity of light, F is frequency. So, for two wavelengths, lambda 1 is equal to this one and lambda 2 is equal to C by F2. Now, what they are asking, ratio of frequency of radiation, that is F1 by F2. So, what is F1 here? F1 is equal to C by lambda 1 and F2 is equal to C by lambda 2. What is F1? C by lambda 1 by C by lambda 2. C is cancelled. This will be lambda 2 by lambda 1. What is lambda 2 here? It is 760 nanometer and it is by 400 nanometer. So, it is approximately equal to 2:1. Our option will be B. 325 nanometer of photon is, so they have given an electrovolt. We have to, when we are calculating in joules, you have to convert into electron volt. See here, 1 electron volt is equal to 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. Then what is 1 joule? 1 joule is equal to 1 by 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 electron volt. Now coming to the formula, the energy. energy of 325 nanometer, that is E is equal to Hc by lambda. We know H is Planck's constant, C is the velocity of light, lambda is given here, that is the wavelength. What is Planck's constant? 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 34. What is velocity of light? 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And by what is lambda? Lambda is given in meter only. So it is 325 into 10 to the power. So nano means it is minus 9. This is in joules. So to convert into an electron volt, what we have to do? You have to divide by this 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19. So I am writing the numbers alone first. 6.6 into 3 by 325 into 1.602. And powers. So what are the powers here? You have 10 to the power minus 34, 10 to the power 8. And 10 to the power minus 9 and 10 to the power minus 19. Solving the power alone first, 10 to the power minus 34 plus 8, and this minus 9 comes to the numerator, it will be plus 9, and minus 19 comes to the numerator, it will be plus 19. So how much it will be? 8 plus 9 plus 19. 8 plus 9 is 17. 17 plus 19 will be 6. And it is 26. So, and it is 36 here. So, what is the power alone? 10 to the power minus 34 plus 36. It will be 10 square. See here, 6.6 into 3 by 325 into 1.602 into 10 square is 100. So, while solving this, so what is the easy method to solve this? You can cancel it and you can solve it. So, whatever easy, you can follow it. So what I am doing is, I am cancelling by 5. This is 65 and this is 20. And again, I am cancelling this by 5 and this is 4. So finally what I am doing, I am cancelling this. So finally, what is this? 6.6 into, not cancelling this, this is 3, 3 into 4 is 12 by 13 into 1.602 into 10. That's all. So after calculating this, you have to multiply and divide, you will be getting 3.8 electron volt. The figure that is not a direct manifestation of quantum motion, quantum nature of atoms. See here, this photoelectrons, we have a photoelectrons. Photoelectrons can be explained by quantum mechanics. Then this one, wavelength and the spectrum is also explained by quantum mechanics. Then here we know black body radiation. Black body radiation will also be explained by quantum mechanics. But this internal energy, this increase in the internal energy is not explained. When temperature increases, there is an increase in internal energy which has limited explanation or which cannot be explained in detail by quantum numbers. This is thermodynamics. So the figure that is not the correct manifestation of quantum number is A. 21, the option is A. Energy of electron in helium plus in second Bohr orbit. So, helium plus means what? Helium, we know its atomic number is 2. It has 2 electrons. Helium plus means how much electron it has? It has only 1 electron. So, So what happens to the another electron? See here, this is n is equal to 1, the ground level, and it is n is equal to 2. The electron goes from this ground level to the higher level. The excitation is from 1 to 2. Now, what is the n value here? N is equal to 2. E, energy is equal to, we know the formula, it is negative of 2.178 into 10 to the power minus 18. You have to remember this. By z square by m square. What is z square? Z square is, z is atomic number. So it is a negative value. We can strike out this and this. So E is equal to minus 2.178 into 10 to the power minus 18 by z square is 2 square. That is atomic number of helium. By what is n value? N is 2. Again 2 square. So cancelling these two, we will be getting energy is equal to minus 2.178 into 10 to the power minus 18. So our option will be D. Question. What is the wavelength of light in meter emitted when electron of hydrogen atoms goes from n is equal to 5 to n is equal to 3? That is, here n is equal to 5 to the lower level, n is equal to 3. So we know the formula, wave number is equal to r into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Here N1 is 3 and N2 is 5. You should not get confused. Wave number is 1 by lambda. What is Rydberg constant? 1.09 into 10 to the power 7 by 1 by, what is N1 square? 3 square minus 1 by 5 square. Now this lambda, now 1 by lambda is equal to, so let us take this as 1.1 into 10 power 7. This is 9 and this is 25. 25 minus 9 by the LCM will be 25 into 9. 1 by lambda is equal to 1.1 into 10 to the power 7. This is 16 by 25 into 9. So, lambda, what is lambda now? Lambda is equal to 25 into 9 by 1.1 into 10 to the power 7 into 16. So, let us take this 25 into 9 by 1.1 into 16 into 10 to the power 10 to the power minus 7. So now we are going to see 10 to the power minus 7 and you have the same sum values here. So which is close to 10 to the power minus 7? 10 power minus 3, 10 power minus 1, 10 power minus 2. Only 10 power minus 6 is close to 10 power minus 7. So while solving, when you are solving this, you will get the answer A. You just to see which is close. 10 power 6 is close. So this will be your answer. That is 1.28 into 10 to the power minus 6. Approximately you will get it. Answer is A. For 23, the answer is A. The de Broglie wavelength of ball of mass 76 gram. So this is ball of mass. For smaller particle, that is electron and protons only, protons will be not taking grams. See, this is, when this is bigger mass, we will be taking in kilograms. That you should be clear. Moving with the velocity 10 meters. So, what is de Broglie wavelength? Lambda is equal to h by mv. That is lambda. We know the Planck's constant. It is 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 34. And what is m? M is 76 by 1000 because we have to convert into kg and what is V? It is 10. So we will be getting, cancelling this, 6.6 by 76 into this this 10 square, this will be coming to the numerator into 10 to the power minus 34. Finally, we will be getting, so if it is 100, this 6600 by 76. So, how much you will be getting while cancelling this into 10 to the power minus 34. So, let me cancel by 4. 1, 4 is 4. 9, 4 is 36. So, 1, 4. Reminder 2. 6, 4 is reminder 2. And 5, 0. It is 1, 6, 5, 0 divided by 19. We'll be getting 8. 8 19s are 152. So, which matches with 8? 8 to 10 power minus 34 meter. Our answer is B. Twenty-fifth question. According to Heisenberg uncertainty principle, the product of uncertainty in position and velocity. So, what is the formula for uncertainty? Heisenberg, delta x into delta p is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. So, they are asking only uncertainty in position and uncertainty in velocity. That means delta x into delta v. We know momentum p is equal to mv, which is greater than or equal to h by 4 pi. Now, delta x into delta v is equal to h by 4 pi and m. This m comes to the denominator. Substituting the values, what is h? H is equal to 6.63 into 10 to the power minus 34 by 4 into, let us take pi as 22 by 7 into 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31. See, 17 is 7, remainder 1, 3. We can cancel it. Then what again we can cancel? So, let us cancel this 6.6. Let us take 6.6 alone. Then let's cancel this 2 and this is 3.3. This is 3.3 and if we are cancelling, it means it is 211 and this is 0.3. Now, you have 0.3 by 2 into 2 will be 4 into 1.3. In the denominator, numerator, 10 to the power minus 34 into 10 to the power plus 31. So, plus 34 and minus 34 and plus 31 will be 10 to the power minus 3. So, 10 to the power minus 3. While solving this, you will be getting, it is approximately equal to 5.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 meter square s power minus 1. That is, you will be getting 0.058 into 10 power minus 3. And by solving this, you will get the answer C. 25th, the option is C. That is 5.8 into 10 to the power 5 minus 5 meter square inverse. Psi square. What is this? This is psi. PSI. Psi square in the Schrödinger wave equation denotes, this is the maximum probability of finding an electron. This psi square is a differential, linear differential equation. It is dealing with the probability of finding an electron, that is maximum probability of finding an electron. The option is B. Which quantum number does not follow from the solutions of Schrödinger wave equation? See, Schrödinger wave equation, linear differential equation, which speaks about principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number and magnetic quantum number, but spin quantum number is only the clockwise and anti-clockwise rotation. So, Schrödinger wave equation does not speak about spin quantum number. The option 27, the option is D. The orbital angular momentum of 2p orbital is, see, to calculate the orbital angular momentum, we have a formula. We know mvr is orbital angular momentum. mvr which is equal to nh by 2 pi if it is only the angular momentum. If it is given orbital angular momentum, what we have to do? Mvr is equal to root of L into L plus 1 by h pi 2 pi. This is a formula you have to remember. What is L? L is a Zinter quantum number. We know L is equal to 0 means it is S, 1 is P, 2 is D, and 3 is F. Here it is given 2P orbital. So it is 2P orbital. What is the value of L? L will be 1. Substituting in this equation, root of 1 into 1 plus 1 into H pi 2 pi. So what will be the value? 1 into 1 plus it is root 2 into H pi 2 pi. So x will be root 2. The option for 28th question is A. The number of angular nodes and radial nodes of 3s orbital. So you have to remember what you have to remember. Total nodes. Formula to calculate total nodes is n minus 1. So what is angular nodes? Angular nodes is corresponding to L. L is 0 means it is S. L is 1 means it is P. L is 2 means it is D. And L is 3 means it is F. Now remaining will be radial nodes. Remaining will be radial nodes. Okay. Now what is N here for 3s orbital? What is N? N is equal to 3. What is total nodes? Total nodes is equal to 3 minus 1, which is 2. Then what is angular nodes? Angular nodes corresponds to the value of L. What is this orbital? This is LS orbital. So angular nodes is 0. And the remaining, that is 2 minus 0 is 2. That will be radial nodes. So what is our option? 0 and 2. It matches the option 0 and 2. It is B. The option for this is B. The electronic configuration of carbon is given. We know atomic number of carbon is 6. It is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So how to fill it? It is 1, 2 and 2p2. The electron is filled singly in the orbit before going to the higher energy level. So this is 2px1 and 2py1. It is explained by the Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. What that means, electron will not pair until all the available orbital contains one electron each. So the 30th question, option is B. 31st, identify the correct valence shell orbital diagram of sulfur. So this is an easy question. So 3s and 3p. So these available orbital is not containing electron. So this is wrong. And here this is paired and all this are singly available and it is again paired. This is correct. There is no electron in that, it is not paired and this is wrong. And here no electron. So this is wrong. Which will be the correct valence shell orbital diagram of sulfur will be B. The option for 31 is B. Which of the following element does not have N minus 1 D5 electronic configuration? See, chromium atomic number is 4. What we have? We have 3D5, 4S1. Then manganese. Manganese atomic number is 25. Here also we have 3D5 and 4S2. So, when comparing molybdenum and niobium, see chromium, molybdenum comes under chromium. Molybdenum comes under chromium. So, this will be also having what electronic configuration? 4d5 and 5s1. Only niobium will not be having this configuration. The option is B. Niobium is not having this N minus 1 D5 configuration. 32, the option is B. Which of the following set of elements exhibit law of triads? So, what is law of triads? The first and third element, the average of first and third, the molecular mass of the average of first and third element will be equal to the molecular mass of the second element. So, I am writing A is lithium, sodium and potassium, B and C is given chlorine, bromine and iodine, and D is all the above. So, what is given? It is 7 and 39. What is 7 plus 39 is 46 by 3, which is 23. So, 23. This follows law of triad. Then, 40 and 137. What is 40 and 137? 177 by 2, which is 88. This is 88. This also follows law of triads. Then, chlorine is 35.5. And it is 127. Adding these two, we will be getting 162.5, which is divided by 2, it will be getting 81.2 something, which is close to this bromium, 81. So, all the above, answer will be all the above. Law of triad is the average of molecular mass of first and third element will be the molecular mass of the second element. 33, the answer is D. Ecker aluminium is known as, so in the Mendeleev periodic table, he gave the gaps, and he named, there will be some elements will be identified in future. So, he called gallium as ecker aluminium. The option will be A. That is 34th is A. He called gallium as ecker aluminium. That means what? Gallium possesses the property similar to aluminium. The option for 34 is A. The maximum number of elements in fourth period is. So, I am giving simple trick to calculate this. So, if the N is even, if N is even, you have to write N plus 2 the whole square by 2. But if N is odd means, what you have to do, you have to put n plus 1 by 2 the whole square, this n plus 1 the whole square by 2. So, it is given fourth period. Fourth period means what? N is even. So, what formula you have to substitute? This formula, n plus 2 the whole square by 2. That means n is 4, 4 plus 2 by 2 the whole square by 2, which is 6 square, 6 into 6 by 2, 3 2s are 6, so you will be having 18 electrons. For 5th period, how will you be calculating? For 5th period, n is odd, that means 5 plus 1 by 2 the whole square, here also 6 square by 2, that is 18 electrons. This is the trick to calculate number of elements in the period. The option is 18 electrons, the option is B. The sixth question, the elements with atomic numbers 19, 37, 55 and 87. See here, it is 19. 19 is potassium. Potassium belongs to group 1. So, we know that lithium, sodium and potassium belongs to group 1. So, our option will be A. 36, the option is A. Match the following. So, this was something tricky. We don't know about palladium, indium and barium. So, how to match this easily? See that group 2 will be S block elements and P block elements starts from group 13 and in between group D will be what block elements? D block elements. So, it is clear that group 2 will be yes. That means A will be having S. Okay. Then B. B means what? So, B is, the group is given 10. 10 means this will be what block element? D block elements. So, D is 3. That means 10 is 3. That means B is D. A is S is, we can mark it as 1. See, clearly I am explaining. We know that second group, these are all groups. These are all groups. Second group belongs to S block element. 13th group belongs to P block elements. And 10th group belongs to D block elements. See, let us first see this group and block only. It is given A. A belongs to what group? S group. So, A will be 1. Clear? And B belongs to, here the next option is B. B is what? 10th group. So, 10th group belongs to D. That means B belongs to 3. And then C. C means what? C given is 13th group. C given is, this is C given is 13th group. 13th group means it belongs to P. So, P means which one? This is 2. Now, where is the option? A is 1, B is 3, C is 2. Here, C, A is 1. Correct? So, A is 1 here. And what is B? B is 3. But it is given B is 2. This is wrong option. Next. B is 3 given. B is 3 is correct. And C is 2 given. C is 2 given. A is 1. This is the correct option. And B 3 is given. Correct. A 2 is given, which is wrong. And here C 3 is given, which is wrong. So, even though we don't know these, we can group with, if you know the group and which group it belongs, S, P and D. The option for this question is 37, it is B. Which of the following D block element has the highest atomic number? So, these are all in a group. See, titanium, zirconium, hafnium and rutherfordium. This will be in the same group. So, this is having, rutherfordium is having higher atomic number. Don't consider this as an F block element. This is a D block element. F block elements are placed separately in the periodic table. The option is D. So, 38, the option is D. Which of the following is the atomic number of metalloid? So, where is metalloid? Metalloid will be present in between metal and non-metal. So, metal we know with zinc, the metal ends with the atomic number 30. And in between you have 31 and 32. So, here 32 is germanium. When we are moving here 33 and 34, it comes, it goes to non-metal. And this 38 will come here and it is a metal. So, which is a metalloid? Germanium is a metalloid which is having atomic number 32. See, metalloid is present in between metal and non-metal. Metal, this is zinc. So, which is nearer to zinc will be the metalloid. The option is, the 38, the option is A, which is a germanium. With reference to the periodic table, choose the bigger atom from each of the following pairs. So, let us take second one. Sc and chlorine, selenium and chlorine. See, when you know chlorine or halogens, which are in the right hand side. Halogens. Which are in the right hand side. That is, when we moving along a period, what happens to the atomic size? The atomic size decreases. So, when we are moving along a period, the atomic size decreases. That means selenium and chlorine, you know, chlorine will be placed in the last. This will be having less atomic size. In this case, Sc will be having more atomic size. So, second one is Sc. So, option D and option C are ruled out. Then coming to oxygen and phosphorus. See, you know, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen. So, below nitrogen, you have phosphorus. what happens to the atomic size when we move down the group, atomic size increases. That means phosphorus will be having more atomic size than oxygen. So which is bigger atom here, oxygen or phosphorus? Phosphorus will be the bigger atom. That means third one is P. This one matches. So option is A. Here see, third one is given oxygen, but third one is P. This option matches. 40, the option is A. Which of the following species will have largest size? The question is, it is largest size. So what we have? We know magnesium is having atomic number 12 and aluminium will be having atomic number 13. When we move from left to right in a period, what happens to the atomic size? Atomic size decreases. Okay, we have to know this. Then you have Mg2+. Mg2+ means what? It loses electron. So the size will be less. Again, Al3+. Al3+ means it loses electron and it will be having smaller size. Size will be small. That means higher the charge on cation, smaller will be size. Then higher the charge on anion means what? Which has negative charge, larger will be size because it gains electron. So these are all cations, it will be having smaller size. When comparing magnesium and aluminium, when moving along a period, what happens to the atomic size? Atomic size decreases magnesium will be having more atomic size than aluminium. See here, the electrons are added in the same subshell. The attraction between the nucleus and the electron increases. So when we are moving along a period, atomic size decreases. Aluminium will be having less atomic size than magnesium. Our option will be B. 41, it is B. Choose the element with higher electron affinity from each of the following pairs. What is electron affinity first? Electron affinity means tendency. It has a greater tendency to accept. That means what? It loves to accept electrons. So it loves to accept electrons. Here, let us go from beryllium. Beryllium and boron. Beryllium, you know the atomic number is 4. See, this is 1s2, 2s2. It is like completely filled. It is boron is 1s2. Atomic number is 5, 1s2, 2s2. 2p1. See, it is completely filled, so it will not accept. It will not. The electron affinity will be less for beryllium. So they are asking higher electron affinity. In the case of beryllium and boron, which will be having more electron affinity? Boron. Because beryllium is having a completely filled ship. So fourth option is B. Which matches fourth option is B? The B and C. Let us strike out A and B. Again, now coming to the, this is fourth option. Now coming to the third option, you have selenium and bromine. So bromine comes under halogens. That means what? It easily gain one electron to attain the stable gas configuration. So bromine will be having higher tendency to accept an electron. Third option will be Br. Third one is Br. Which matches BrC? Third matches Br. So our option is C. 42, the option is C. This is easy question. The tendency of an atom to attract shared pair of electron towards itself is called electronegativity. We call it as electronegativity. It attracts shared pair. That means it gains or it has the tendency to attract shared pair of electrons. It is one of the electrons towards itself. The option is, that is 43, the option is A. The electron gain enthalpy of fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. So, what is electron gain enthalpy means? How much easily it can accept the electron. It is electron gain enthalpy. See, this is chlorine will be having more electron gain enthalpy than fluorine, than bromine and than iodine. See, fluorine is having this less negative value of electron gain enthalpy because due to the small size, there will be higher repulsion. Due to the small size, the electron density will be more. The electron density. What is electron density? The electrons present around the atom. The electron density will be more. So, there will be higher repulsion when one electron is added. What happens? It has a less negative value of electron gain enthalpy. Chlorine will be having more electron gain enthalpy compared to fluorine. So, our option will be, when we are comparing what they have given, fluorine, the first should come will be fluorine. Fluorine should be smaller than chlorine. So, where it is smaller than chlorine, see fluorine here, it is, fluorine is, here, what is the option? Minus 333. This is fluorine and this is chlorine and this is bromine and this is iodine. So, chlorine is having maximum value here. Fluorine is having less value. The option is A. Here, this is wrong. And when comparing this iodine, fluorine will be having, this is wrong. So, this is the order. Chlorine will be having more negative gain enthalpy than the fluorine, bromine and iodine. The option is A. Last question, match the column. So, you have to match acidic, basic, amphoteric and neutral. The first thing what we know, Al2O3, aluminium, is an amphoteric. So, we are reading from smaller classes. That is, fourth one is C. And then, see the calcium oxide. Calcium, this is a metal with an oxide, will be a basic. We know calcium will be basic. That is, first one will be B. So, what are these? The first one is B. So, this is B. And the fourth one is C. So, the option matches D, which is all other options are wrong option. The 45th question, the option is D. That means, Al2O3 is amphoteric, CaO is basic, carbon dioxide, which is a non-metal acid, this is an acidic, and NO is neutral. The option is D. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel for more videos.